Hey guys, welcome to Super Metroid on the Super Nintendo. A lot of super going on here. One of my favorite games of all time, definitely my favorite Metroid in the series, though the Game Boy Advance ones were damn good as well. And of course you can't forget the Prime series, I did really like the first Prime. Anyways, yeah, we're gonna head down to the space colony. This is Super Metroid, this is essentially what the game is gonna look like for the duration. You're gonna have Samus jumping around here. She can shoot around, like so, diagonal up and down. And you can hit, oh, you can't hit the start menu here. Oh, we just need to progress on then. You can see your health on the top left and a map of our current area. Right now we're in Ceres Station. Things are getting really serious here. And we're gonna see what's going on. There was a distress signal. So we're just gonna press on through these doors. Normally when you're playing the game, you actually have to shoot out the doors. Okay, we got some dead bodies here. This game, I'm a little hesitant to actually do a series on it because it's actually, in my opinion, at least this is how I feel, the most immersive Super Nintendo game. It's definitely the most immersive that I've ever played. I really get into this, so I'm not entirely sure if I'm going to be able to commentate over it, but we're going to find out. There's the Metroid. We've saved the day. Metroid's totally fine. Don't stand too close to the bugger and thing. Seriously. There's Ridley. If you ever played Metroid, you may recognize him. He looks very different than his NES counterpart. So this guy, you don't really, oh good, goodness gracious me, I didn't mean to get hit there. You don't need to worry about him too much. Ultimately, if you take too much damage, the fight just ends. You literally can't lose this. However, for bragging rights, I would like to see if I could get him dead before, you know, my health drops too low and the fight ends. Because, well, one, fuck me, that hurts. One, I don't want that annoying beeping to go on when your health gets critically low. You hear a beep constantly, and I don't want you guys to suffer. You know, there will be suffering in this LP, but let's not start off the first video with a little bit of suffering. The fucking tail got me, are you kidding me? And there's our first curse word, wonderful. But yeah, I'd like to get the shit out of here, Ridley, I hate you. He's super red, we can do this. Come on, come on. This is gonna happen. This is going to happen, Ridley. You're not gonna take this from me, man. Come on, drop the fucking Metroid! Oh, there it is. We're already failing in the series. Basically, if you do enough damage to him, oh god, self-destruct sequence. He drops the Metroid and then picks it up and does that exact animation where he runs through the station. Ultimately, not much has changed. Just for bragging rights, really, is the only reason I want it. I'm sorry, corpses. I don't have time to bury you. We're just gonna get the hell out of Dodge. Yeah, you hear that little bloop, bloop, bloop. Hopefully we won't hear that, you know, the rest of the game, because I like to think I'm relatively good at this. Which brings me to another point. I'm gonna be trying to beat this without a guide. I mean, I know I can beat it without a guide, but I would like to 100% it for you all. However, I don't think I remember where every item is. It's been, well, what has it been, a year? I had a friend come over and I just played through it one night because I love this game so much. It's been a little while since I played through this. So, if you guys want to help along in the comments, you know, if I miss an item, I'm gonna try and record only one a day. And I would love the help. Woo, there we are. Out of the station, just in the nick of time. We follow Ridley all the way down to Planet Zeebs. He has the last Metroid in hand. We need to see if we can't recover this thing. Down we go. Seriously though, the graphics, holy crap. You really haven't gotten much of the music yet, but literally everything in this game is fucking masterfully made. The graphics, the sound, the gameplay, the exploration, it's literally incredible in every way. And oh my goodness, I get so immersed in this fucking game. Because you're so alone in this situation, right? The only dialogue you have in the damn game is what you see at the beginning, and that's pretty much it. The rest, it's just you on your own in this massive world, exploring around, finding items, fighting horrible monsters. Whew, I can just go on and on about it. Check out these graphics. The lightning striking, we got rain coming down. The music, very eerie. Our descent back into Zeebs. This is the planet that we were on originally in Metroid 1. Admittedly, I haven't played through Metroid 1. I have watched videos on it. I'm not too fond of the game, to be completely honest. I get horribly lost and it's awfully difficult for me. I'm just kind of a Metroid scrub. And when it comes to Metroid, this is the one that I played the most as a kid. And I just was like immediately in love. Alright, so down we go. We don't really have any choice at the moment. We kind of have a set path. We could try going in here. Ultimately, though, it's going to be a dead end, as you can see. We can't really squeeze our way into tight corners yet, tight little corridors. So we're just going to keep going on down, and red doors cannot be opened by traditional means. Also, I briefly showed off our start menu here. You're going to see, you know, the areas we've been to are in criteria right now. And we can go to our status menu, which is a big improvement from previous Metroid games, where we can equip and unequip items at will. We don't have Jack Diddley right now, though, so let's just keep heading down. And this is the part... Oh, wait, we're not at an elevator yet. I've been working so hard to figure out this elevator situation. I can't wait to show it off for you guys. This part is a very long descent downwards. And again, if you've played the original, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then you go to the left a little bit. Yeah, you make it all the way down. I remember that. God, I am lazy. But yeah, if you remember, if you played through the original, you're going to see quite a few familiar scenes, namely this particular area here. This is where we took down Mother Brain for the first time. Oh, this place is very harrowing from what I understand. So let's just make our way over to the other side. Keep pressing on. You know, Ridley came down here. Oh god, here's an elevator. Look at how sweet this looks. Oh. This doesn't mean jack shit to you guys, but look up another Super Metroid series online somewhere and look at how the elevator looks, and it flickers in and out of existence. It looks terrible. Also, when you take damage, if you're trying to record an emulator, Samus will flicker in and out of existence as well. It's very annoying. Here I have the transparency working 100%, so it's awesome. Morphing Ball, our first item of the game. Everything seems abandoned until we pick this item up. Suddenly we've been spotted. Yeah, this little eyeball in the sky. You can't shoot it or anything. And also the statues underneath us come alive. And if you want to use the morph ball, you just hit down twice. You can roll into a little ball. Can you see me now? Oh, we lost sight of me. Also, yeah, so it wants us to like shoot this and go through. But I know a lot of weird tricks in this game, like wall jumping. And so expect me to sequence break, maybe? I could easily sequence break the shit out of this game. I've done it before. I'm gonna try and keep everything kind of the way it's intended to be played. However, I'm not entirely sure if I'm gonna be able to restrain myself. I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys. We're gonna head down and get some missiles. Missiles are used to open up red doors and also do decent amount of damage to regular enemies and stuff like that, and bosses and whatnot. Just hit the select button, you can select them. And for me, hitting X cancels out the item selection. Yeah, I have to change the buttons around by default. The game wants you to like shoot with X and jump with A. I'm not entirely sure why. I'm not a big fan of it, so I always switch it over to like shoot as Y and B as jump, like the traditional platformy buttons. Alrighty, we're gonna press onwards here, breaking through that missile door. Oh wait, check this out. Is it right here? Yeah, I remember that. That's an item. We don't know what that item is yet, so we're just gonna pass it for now. Pick up another missile tank. We're gonna be back in this area in the very distant future. For now, this is all we can get. Yeah, you may notice these blocks look a little suspicious here. There's so many secret areas in this game. You can just explore around. Enjoy the environments and the creepy music and, oh, and the enemies. Oh, just every, I could go on and on about this game. I really like this style of Metroid game. And like I think I mentioned before, I've been talking a lot, I'm already forgetting. The Game Boy, oh, those statues turned. The Game Boy Advance Metroid games also were just so amazing to me. I really enjoyed them. Then you got into Prime, which was like the first 3D Metroid. And I remember stepping out of my ship for the first time and watching the rain hit my visor. And it was just absolutely incredible. Metroid for me, it's always been about immersion and just incredible gameplay. So be careful. As soon as you step out of that door, whoop, we're going to be accosted by space pirates here. So you can see, you use your ball to, really lower your hitbox and dodge a lot of harmful situations. These are just basic space pirates, really don't need to worry about them too much. One simple shot with our regular gun takes them down, no problem at all. This part's a little tricky. Also, check this out. There is a secret. Oh, I don't have bombs yet, of course. Oh, spoiler alert, there are bombs. There's actually a secret right there. However, it literally means nothing to us at this point. We really can't gain any items. We're just gonna try and cheese our way up this wall a little bit, not worry about the platforms. Oh yeah, I got my wall jumping down. I'm feeling pretty good. The wall jumping is a little weird in this game. It's not a trick that they just spell out for you. It's one that you have to learn on your own. Some little natives to the area can teach you. But even then, as a kid, I just didn't understand what the fuck was going on. And so I had to like, how did I learn? I must have learned from the little monster dudes. Anyways, to wall jump, you have to like make sure you're doing a flip. And then when you're up against the wall, hit the opposite direction and jump at the same time. You can do a wall jump. It's a little tricky to pull off. Ultimately, in the grand scheme of things, though, it's not too hard to do. Also, these are health pickups. I kind of pass them over. These large ones restore, what is it, 20? The small ones are 5, something like that. Hopefully, we won't be needing too much of that. Let's just keep pressing on upwards. As you can see, you know, with the music change, that's a good sign. I forgot to mention that. We have the traditional music going on here, and it is just amazing. That door on the left, it's still a dead end, we're not gonna worry about it. But yeah, with the music change, everything has suddenly come alive. Monsters are spawning, there are space pirates everywhere, there's shit coming out of the walls. Ugh, get out of here. 3 hits on those guys. Oh my gosh. So amazing. Those are missile drops, the ones that I just picked up there. They restore 2 of your missile supply. We're going to be getting a lot of missiles. When you step into a room like this, you can download map data. It'll show off a majority of the area. It still won't show off a lot of these secret rooms that you have to find on your own. Wrecked ship, huh? Meridia. Oh my gods, Meridia. And then there's Brinstar down there. I'm going to pronounce it Brinstar, and if you have a different pronunciation, just deal with it, honestly. But yeah, we're just going to head on out here and just press on. We got to find some items, stuff to break down walls and progress, basically. Get out of here. You guys are super annoying. These little fly demons. Alrighty, awesome, possum. Things are off to a great start. And here, on the left, you may see an S there on the map in the top right. That is actually a save room. We go into there, we can save our progress. We will be hitting that up very shortly. For now, though, I want to head all the way back up. No point in going to the save room quite yet. There's literally no way that I can die. We can't go through this wall here on the left, so let's just go ahead and keep moving on through this cave. Gotta be careful. Whoa, I got really lucky there. Surprised I didn't take a hit. When you shoot those green dudes, and forgive me, I don't necessarily know all the enemy names. I know the boss names, that's pretty much it. But when you shoot those green dudes, they explode into a hail of just green shit. Green guano, so yeah, they'll hit you if they actually connect with you. Gotta be careful. Open this missile door and get the hell out of here. No, we have to go get this item. Alrighty, check this out. We now have bombs. When we're in a ball, basically hit the Y button and we can drop a fat bomb on the ground to do damage, break through walls, and we couldn't get through the door. Drat. When a door is gray, you have literally no way, oh god, of opening it. Just gonna hide here. Yeah, you have to fulfill certain requirements in order to open the door. Alright, so we have to fight our first real boss here. He likes to shoot these eggs into the air, which you can resupply with. Otherwise, you just want to drill them in the chest with your missiles. And even your regular shots actually do a decent amount of damage too. Nothing to worry about here. Again, shoots eggs in the air. Just go ahead and go into your crouching position. Do some shots. Oh god, now he's super fast. There we go. No problem at all. Still at full health. When you beat a boss, the room is gonna fill up with delicious prizes. Normally it'll have like health and stuff, but again, I was at full health. Enemies won't drop anything that you don't need, really. So if you need missiles, you will get missile drops. If you don't need missiles, well, you're gonna get whatever the hell else you need. Awesome, so now that we have bombs, we can actually make a little bit more forward progress. Namely, that wall that was there on the left in this main hallway. And also, yeah, you see like little blocks like this. That's what a bomb looks like. You can use it to bomb jump, which is something I'm not entirely good at. Basically, people are able to propel themselves up to great heights with their ability to bomb jump. Me, not so much. I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys. We need to head over to the left. That's where the main story gets going here. However, there are a few items below us that we need to grab. There's actually a really well-hidden pickup that we're gonna grab here in just a moment. For now, we're not going to hit the S just yet. We're going to go into this room, and we should be able to grab yet another item. That is something that's basically what's going to happen in this game, is we're going to go around questing for items, all sorts of hidden stuff, try and get ourselves as beefy as possible, and recover the lost Metroid. Yes, going to get a missile power up here. I'm looking around the room. Nothing seems out of the ordinary. Even in these rooms where you pick up items like this one, do a little scan of the area, see if you see any blocks that are out of place, something like that, that you may be able to destroy, because there's shit literally hidden all throughout this game. You can actually bomb jump here, take a little bit of a shortcut all the way back up. There are all sorts of blocks too, like, you have the regular bombable blocks, there are also blocks that'll break underneath your feet, and then like respawn immediately, blocking you out of certain areas. We will be seeing a lot of those in the future. Now I'm actually going to head all the way back down, just shooting downwards. 1, 2, count the platforms so you can get down as quick as possible. I forgot to count, but I think I got it. Yeah, nice. And when you head back into the main room here, where you fought Mother Brain for the first time, you can actually break this middle platform here and get yourself another fabulous prize hidden underneath Mother Brain's chamber. Who would have thunk it all this time playing Metroid 1? You could have, yeah, after you killed Mother Brain, it's completely pointless. But you could have got yourself a sweet missile pickup, Samus. What are you doing with your life, honestly? Sweet. Now we have that. I, unfortunately, have to climb all the way back up. So, I suppose, if I can get my fat head through this fucking hole in the ground, holy shit. Oh, wait. There was one more thing I wanted to show you guys. What is happening in this cartoon? Oh, my goodness. Samus's fat, armored head. Check this out. This is a room that literally means nothing to us right now. It's blocked off, we can't do anything. Just remember it for later. Alright, let me get the hell back up this long-ass tube here. Alrighty, here we go, we're back out. One more thing I want to make note of for you guys, so we're all clear here, is that I'm just going to be playing this game for fun. There are actually multiple endings depending on how fast you can clear the game and all that good shit. I'm just playing this for fun, man. If we beat it in a certain amount of time, that's wonderful. But for now, we're not going to worry about it. We're just going to let this game totally entrance and mystify us with its splendor. Oh my goodness. Fortunately, we're done for today, so I'm going to save up. And as always, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you tomorrow. Have a great night.